Pyrrhus now had neither enemies to fight, nor pressing disputes to manage. It was the first period of prolonged peace that he had experienced in many years. And he hated every minute of it. Men like him are built for war, and they start to break down come peacetime. Pyrrhus was looking for any excuse to rally his men again, and he soon found one. The Greek colonies in Italy had long been regarded as unimportant outposts in barbarian lands, but now they were under threat from the ever-expanding Republic of Rome. When a call for aid came from the city-state of Tarentum, Pyrrhus jumped at the opportunity. All that I could do was try and convince him to stay and enjoy his hard-won peace. "If we can conquer Rome," he told me as he was drawing up his invasion plans, "all of Italy will soon be ours. And if we can defeat the Romans, then Sicily, Libya, and Carthage should be easy pickings." "And when all of these lands are yours, what will you do?" I asked. He replied, "Why, we will celebrate, of course. We will sing and drink and be at ease after all of our troubles." "Then what, pray tell, is preventing us from drinking and passing our time right now, instead of starting yet another war?" "If happiness and celebration is your goal, my friend, then you have already achieved it." Pyrrhus could give no good answer, but his mind was already set. He would become the liberator of the Greeks in Italy and put the Roman barbarians in their place. However, a raging storm hit our fleet as we sailed for Italy. With his army scattered to the winds, Pyrrhus made landfall near Tarentum with only a fraction of the men that he had assembled.
Our forces were scattered by the storm, but we cannot go looking for survivors yet. We must hurry to Tarentum before the Romans assault the town.
Mm-hmm. Valor. That ghastly wound cannot go untreated. We will continue the battle without you.
The main Roman army has laid siege to our allies in Heraclea. We will provide you with whatever resources we can spare if you drive these barbarians out of Megale Eras.
Praise the gods. The main army has found us at last.
Many of the smaller Greek settlements in Italy are under siege, and some have already fallen to the Romans. If we are to win this war, we must liberate as many as we can.
You keep buzzing around me like an irksome fly, Pyrrhus. Does your famed courage only stretch to fighting small garrisons, or are you man enough to face me in the field?
Free at last. You can count on us to support the war effort.
Rut Erectus. Evil Tardis.
From this camp, we can strike at the Roman army.
Abadactus. Erectus. Erectus. Somus. 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 Evil Tardis. Onus. Evil,
time has come. Let us show these decadent colonizers the true might of Rome.
We have captured another Greek settlement.
The Romans are sending raiders towards our position. We may have to deal with them, unless we want them at our backs when we face the brunt of Livinus's army.
Ah, there you are, my lord. I must say, sailing straight into a raging storm was not your brightest idea.
Where, I ask, is their supposed safety? Still hiding in the countryside.
About time, I say. These Romans have been loitering all over our great king for 34 years now.
Heraclea is lost. You have failed us, Pyrrhus.
Our forces were scattered by the storm, but we cannot go looking for survivors yet. We must hurry to Tarentum before the Romans assault the town.
Rocket.
The main Roman army has laid siege to our allies in Heraclea. We will provide you with whatever resources we can spare if you drive these barbarians out of Megale Eras.
Many of the smaller Greek settlements in Italy are under siege, and some have already fallen to the Romans. If we are to win this war, we must liberate as many as we can.
Has found us at last.
Free at last. You can count on us to support the war effort.
Captured another Greek settlement.
Never fear, men. As long as I remain standing, I will fight right alongside you.
You keep buzzing around me like an irksome fly, Pyrrhus. Does your famed courage only stretch to fighting small garrisons, or are you man enough to face me in the field?
About time, I think. These Romans have been loitering all over our pristine streets for years now.
These Romans build organized camps and deploy their armies at new formations. They do not seem like barbarians to me. From this camp, we can strike at the Roman army. Now coming in from so many great towns, we can equip our forces with even better weapons in here.
My lord. I must say, sailing straight into a raging storm was not your brightest idea.
The time has come. Let us show these decadent colonizers the true might of Rome.
fight, my lord. That ghastly wound cannot go untreated.
We will continue the battle without you.
Want them at our backs when we face the brunt of Lyvina's army. Is saved, but the Romans still control a camp near Asculum. Let us march north and defeat them in their own backyard.
I've captured another Greek settlement. The Romans for generations and would be happy to lend you our support. We ask only that you clear out the Romans occupying our capital.
Were once a great civilization. But your neglect and decadence will be your downfall. When this day is over, All of Italy will belong to Rome.
Your help. We will provide you with whatever we can.
Sent us far, of course. We are glad to be reunited with you, my lord.
Thank you.
last of the settlements. All of Megala Hellas is under our control!
Whoa!
Evil guardian.
We have captured stolen loot from the raiders' camp!
day.
Somus.
Rare.
Correct.
Right.
Abadak.
Correct.
Right.
Somus.
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 Abadak.
Somus.
I can.
Abadak.
Abadak.
How Romans fight without their rations.
What you saw today was but a fraction of Rome's true power. We will be back!
Acragia, Romans fled in panic before Pyrrhus's war elephants. When we fought them again at Asculum, they had already adapted to this strange new weapon. And they sent out twin chariots with long robes between them to down the fearsome creatures. The Italian expedition never became the quick victory that Pyrrhus had hoped for. The Tarentines seemed content to let him do their fighting for them. And while he bested the Romans twice in battle, each victory came at the cost of thousands of his best men.
One more victory like this, and I will be undone. He told me at one point, and I feared that it was true. Yet he refused to give up hope.
Pyrrhus's ambition was to build a Western Empire from which he would conquer all of Alexander's old domains. If Italy could not be easily cowed, he would simply have to turn elsewhere.